Here we go. Stand by. Music.
Roll it.
Have fun. Enjoy yourselves.
This is going to be tough because everybody is doing well.
Zoom.
You did a great job and you were really in the zone of who you are.
It actually felt sincere. It felt believable.
Zoom it.
Fantastic.
Yes. That's what you need to do, and if you keep doing it, you'll be at the front of this competition.
For sure.
5, 4,
come on, you guys.
3, 2, 1, music up.
2, 2.
Thank you.
I'm Ryan Seacrest. First off, many thanks. We had 33 million votes registered last night, so thank you very much. And tonight, we've got another dose of your results. But that's not the only thing going on. Shakira and Rascal Flatts are here. Plus, performances from Sons of Sylvia and Lady Antebellum. So it's going to be fun. Big lineup, and they've got front row seats for all the action. Your judges, Randy Jackson. Ellen DeGeneres. Cara Diaguardi. And Simon Cowell. So we're going to start things off with something very special. One of country music's hottest groups. Tonight, they're singing their smash, Unstoppable. Ladies and gentlemen, yeah! Give it up for Rascal Flatts!
So you made a lot of mistakes. Walked down the road a little sideways. Cracks a brick when you hit the wall. Yeah, you've had a pocket full of regrets. Pull you down faster than a sunset. It happens to us all. When the cold hard rain just won't quit and you can't see a way out of it, you find your faith has been lost and shaken. You take back what's been taken. Get on your knees and dig down deep. You can do what you think is impossible. Keep on believing, don't give in. A little come and make you whole again. Little is will, it always ends up. Love is unstoppable, yeah. Love, it can weather any storm. Bring you back to being born again. A helping hand when you need it most. The lighthouse shining on the coast that never goes dim. When your heart is full of doubt and you think that there's no way out, you find your faith has been lost and shaken. You take back what's been taken. Get on your knees and dig down deep. You can do what you think is impossible. Keep on believing, don't give in. Been taken, get on your
Rascal Flatts, ladies and gentlemen. Woo! What's up, brother? Hey, good to see you again. So, come on over here, Gary.
All right.
So it's your third time on Idol, isn't it? Doing this for a while.
Yeah. Third or fourth.
You guys are getting ready to go out on tour?
Yeah, starts in June. We're in the studio cutting the new album now, so.
Now, picture this. In just a little bit, Rascal Flatts and Shakira together. Picture that. Can you tease it a little bit? What are we gonna see? We're gonna see a little. I don't know if I can do that. My hips will lie. When we come back, we've got your results live and more with Rascal Flatts. One of those six will be leaving. Stay with us on American Idol. Back with you live on American Idol. Tonight, one more person must exit the stage. And as we inch closer and closer to the finale, nobody wants to leave, especially at this point. They've become so close. They become friends. Take a look at some behind-the-scenes footage behind the Ford music video. Watch this. This is a good one.
Today, we become vampires.
We are about to do our transformations to become creatures of the night.
I've never been a vampire before, so.
Today, they're supposed to be super creepy, attractive undead vampires. A lot more pale skin, really cool contacts.
Hi.
Really cool fangs. That's a lot different.
The sun is shining, the birds are chirping, and I look like a vampire.
All right, we're all made up now, and we're ready to go eat Mike. There's plenty to go around.
I just found out I'm the one being attacked.
Today I'm trying to get the idols to get into a bit more of a sinister role of a vampire. I think they have some pent-up darkness that they're having some fun with.
I feel very mysterious and dead, or undead, really.
They all look pretty good. Siobhan is freaky, and Crystal's eyes are, like, tripping me out. I can't really look her in the eye right now. Casey's over there with his Hollywood vampire action. Casey, wave hello to the folks.
What? My favorite part about being a vampire is definitely the eyes.
It kind of gives you an opportunity to just be kind of crazier and have fun with it.
Thank you. Good luck. The idol's a wrap.
Really, I'm trying to sleep here. It's daytime. If you don't get the camera out of my face, I'm going to bite you. Seriously.
Go to AmericanIdol.com to watch all the Ford music videos and see how you could visit the set of one, plus get tickets to the show. Also find out how you could drive an American Idol-inspired Ford Fiesta with extra garlic. Now, you know, I am never one to turn down a job. So over the weekend, I sent the top six over to meet the director of Shrek Forever After, in which I have a small but pivotal part. Let's take a look at this.
So come on in.
Awesome.
Huh? I'm Mike Mitchell. I'm the director of Shrek Forever After, and I'm going to show you guys how voices are sometimes put into animated films.
The idols are going to take a stab at voicing my scene from the film.
How about one of those famous Shrek roars?
So let's see if you can do better than Ryan Seacrest.
Oh, no.
You guys ready? Here we go. We're going to roll it and hit it.
Oh, we're starting already?
Yeah. Okay, take it back.
As long as you're not...
Daddy's getting away. Do something.
I can't believe it's Yoda.
I'm in a great mood, actually.
You're doing it as Arnold Schwarzenegger for some strange reason.
Dude, again, trust me. Let's put hands because you're walking on me.
Okay, the actors have taken over now. I have no idea how to direct this sequence. Can we try it one more time? Let's do it.
Oh, I'm gonna lick me a rainbow.
Donkey.
As long as you're not doing anything.
I'm one of those famous Shrek roars.
Sure there are.
Hold it together. Just hold it together.
Dad is getting away. Do something.
That was amazing. So you guys got it. So now that you know how it's done, then let's go see a screening of Shrek Forever After.
The top six met up with Shrek stars Eddie Murphy, Antonio Banderas, and myself to greet a few fans before the special screening. Then we invited 250 of our new friends to join us in the theater.
I think this is the best Shrek movie yet. So, dim the lights, and here we go. Enjoy.
Puss?
What happened to you?
I have all the cream I can drink and all the mice I can chase. I'll get him later.
And you are a catastrophe.
And you are redonkulous.
Fiona, I'm so happy I found you.
Where did we find that guy?
Movie was hilarious. Movie was great.
It really was. I think it was the best 3D movie I've seen.
Actually, I thought Ryan's three lines outshone on everybody. He was Oscar worthy.
And we are joined by two stars from the film, Cameron Diaz and Antonio Banderas, ladies and gentlemen. I will say that Fiona is much hotter in person, wouldn't you say?
Absolutely.
Yes.
She's CGI, anyway. In 3D.
So this Shrek film is actually emotional, wouldn't you say? I got a Lita Wise eye. I didn't cry, but I got like a little...
It's a little tearful.
Yeah, it's a little tearful.
There's new beginnings and also endings in this film. So there's you get to fall in love all over again with each of the characters, and then because it's our last one, we have to say goodbye to them, so...
Why'd you get so plump?
Well, you know, it's tearful because when I see my size in the movie, I cried, actually. Big time. Absolutely.
Well, it is fantastic. You guys should check it out. When does it actually come out, Antonio?
21st of May. For audiences all around America in 3D. This is the last one.
This
is the last one.
This is it. 3D, the last... Really? It's really the last one?
Yeah.
Okay.
That's what they tell us.
That's what they tell us for now. All right. So I hear you want to host.
No. No. I don't know how to do that.
Okay.
I don't know how
to do that.
You are fantastic. You are... Probably the best host in the world.
He really is. You are the best host in
the world. Ever.
You know what? Good night, everybody. See you next week. Thank you. Thank you very much. Just do this. Just go. Dim the light. Do it like Puss in Boots. Dim the lights and here we go. Go ahead.
Dim the lights and here we go. Dim the lights.
There you go.
And here we go.
Dim the lights and here we go. Cameron, Antonio, thank you very much. Good to see you both. All right. Congratulations on the movie. All right, now, let us get serious here. It's time for your results. The lights are down, so let's get to it. I'm going to be forming three groups of two on the stage. Good luck to all of you. Here we go. Siobhan, would you please stand up? You sang Any Man of Mine. Simon compared one of the notes at the end to the sound of someone giving birth. Apparently, he's volunteering at the hospital. But everyone liked your song choice. Randy loved your country punk vibe. Kara said you are back in the competition. What was it like singing the Shania song in front of her?
It was a bit intimidating, but at the same time, it was a really big honor. So it was wicked cool.
Wicked cool. All right. Would you head to the far side of the stage and form the first group on the other end? Siobhan Magnus, ladies and gentlemen. Aaron Kelly, stand up, sir. You sang, you got away. The judges all praised your performance. Ellen loved how you embraced the lyrics, especially when she thought you were 16 years old. Kara and Simon agreed with her, saying it was believable and sincere.
And Randy thought you found your wheelhouse. What'd you see differently from him last night, Randy?
I think, you know, listen, this is his week. He loves country music. He loves these boys that you just saw, Rascal Flatts. And I think this is where he wants to be and where he will be in the future. So I love seeing you in your element.
And for now, head to the center of the stage, Aaron. Aaron Kelly. Michael Lynch, please stand up. Big Mike. You sang "It Only Hurts When I'm Breathing." Kara loved the way you put your mark on such a well-written song. Ellen compared it to Luther Vandross' performance. And Simon agreed that, he said he liked it, but he found it to be a little wet and a little girly. And I felt like you didn't get a chance to explain last night what you meant by that.
Imagine you singing.
Okay.
Do we have to?
So, is that a compliment?
Take it any way you want.
Thank you. By the way, I'm flattered. Mike, would you stand here, closest side to me? Lee DeWise, stand up, sir. You sang, you're still the one. Randy thought you did a pretty good job. Ellen loved how you put your stamp on it. Simon thought it was the perfect song choice. Was it hard for you to make such a well-known song your own, Lee?
Yeah. I mean, when we first actually got, you know, the genre, I said to myself I wasn't gonna do that song, believe it or not. And then I kind of just started playing it and I liked it. So I connected with it the most, so I picked it.
Okay, I want you to go to the far side of the stage with Siobhan, please. Lee DeWise. Casey James, ladies and gentlemen. You sang "Don't." The judges all agreed that this performance exemplified you as an artist. Kara thought it was vulnerable and raw. And Ellen said it was your best performance to date. Kara, you think this put him back in the game in a big way?
Yes. I mean, I've always been a huge believer in you, Casey, and not because you're good looking, because you're really talented, really. And, you know, you've buried your range week after week in songs and covered them up with guitar. And last night we heard what you can do and how you can take a song and make it really emotional for you. And I think everybody connected with that.
Casey, would you join Michael Lynch, please, here? And last but not least, Crystal Bowersox, please stand up. You sang "No One Needs to Know." The judges didn't love it, but they thought you did a good job. Randy loved seeing you mix it up. Kara enjoyed your honest rendition. And Simon compared it to a performance he might see in a coffee shop. So, Ellen, as a panel, it's the first time that you guys didn't all totally love the song choice and the performance. Do you think she's in danger tonight?
Just because of that?
Yeah.
No, I don't think America's that fickle. I think that, have you ever been in the bottom three? Never, right?
I don't think so.
I mean, listen, you are always, always good. It just was not one of our favorite performances. I thought it was just not as strong as the rest, but I don't know. No, you're not in trouble. I feel.
Crystal, darling, would you head to the center and join Aaron, please? So take a look. Here's what we got. Big Mike and Casey right here. Aaron and Crystal here in the center. And you've got Lee and Siobhan on the other end. But who's in the bottom three tonight after your vote? Take a good look. Siobhan, walk with me towards the couches, darling. And just hold right there next to Casey. This is your bottom three. This is what your votes have decided. Everyone on this side is safe. Congratulations, Lee, Aaron, and Crystal. You three are safe. You may take a seat. Come on over here, Michael. Casey and Siobhan. So that's what we've got. Michael, Casey, and Siobhan are your bottom three. On the other side of the break, we come back with Sons of Sylvia. They'll take the stage, and we'll find out who is headed home. Don't go anywhere. This is Live American Idol. Welcome back to the show. This just in. Next week, Harry Connick Jr. will mentor the top five in the Songs of Sinatra. So you can check out the list of tracks the contestants will choose from by heading to iTunes. You can also download video and audio from all of this week's performances as well. Now, to introduce the next performance tonight, please welcome our own Grammy Award-winning superstar, Carrie Underwood. Hey, Carrie.
I'm here tonight to welcome to the stage three guys who mean a lot to me. We've been making music together pretty much ever since I walked off this stage about 5 years ago. And now you can catch them out on tour with me all year long. I am such a fan. You guys have to check out their new album. With Love Left to Lose, put your hands together for Sons of Sylvia. Woo!
Here it is. The last day of my life and I'm jumping in. Here it is. One step into space and I'm falling in. And I ain't got a parachute. And I ain't got a parachute. Like you. It was you. You and me. We have a little world where I wanna be. But when I'm hurting you, and that world is hell and it's killing me. I'm living with an open wound, hoping that it cools it soon. And I don't want to leave, but I should be. I hear you say, oh, what you waiting for?
Like from here. Good to see you guys. Thank you for being with us. One of the Kardashians is here. Remember, you can check out your top 10 idols live in their cross-country summer tour, which kicks off July 1st in Auburn Hills, Michigan. Tickets are on sale the weekend of May 14th. It's AmericanIdol.com for all the information. We're going to continue the music right now with a group that's currently dominating the charts. The song they're performing tonight just went triple platinum with Need You Now. Here's Lady Antebellum. So this is your bottom three, America. Michael, Casey, and Siobhan. Whose journey will come to an end? Find out after Rascal Flatts performs again, this time with Shakira, after the break. Thank you for choosing Idol tonight. Don't forget to check out iTunes for a list of tracks that contestants will choose their songs from when Harry Connick Jr. mentors Sinatra Week. Now, she has apparently just arrived. Okay, let's do the intro. We have a very special duet on the Idol stage for you. For the first time ever with her song Gypsy, put your hands together for Shakira and Rascal Flatts.
Thank you. spent the weekend sewing the pieces back on. Crimson dolls pass me by. Working gets too boring when you learn how to fight. Now the homecoming kind. Take the double, but who knows what you might find. Won't confess all my sins. You can bet on trying, but you can always win. Cause I'm a gypsy. Well, are you coming with me? I might steal your clothes and wear funny faith in me. Never made agreements, just like a gypsy. And I won't back down, cause life's already bit me. And I won't cry, I'm too young to die if you won't quit me. Cause I'm a gypsy. Cause I'm a gypsy. I say, hey, you're no fool if you say. Just the way life goes. People think what they don't know. I say, hey, no, you're no fool if you say no. And it's just the way life goes. People think what they don't know. Ride.
Come along for the ride.
Cause I'm a gypsy. Are you coming with me? I might steal your clothes and wear them if they fit me. I never made agreements, just like a gypsy. And I won't back down, this life's already bit me. And I won't try, I'm too young to die if you don't quit me. Cause I'm a gypsy.
And Shakira. Gary and Shakira, I never thought I'd see that. How are you? Good to see you, darling.
Good morning.
Excellent. All right, so what was it like to move your hips with her?
You saw my...
I saw you trying.
Little effort. Yeah.
I recommended him to wear a skirt, but he's got one.
Yeah. So the contestants who are going to be here next week, what advice do you have from your point of view? You've done so much at such a young age.
You know, I think it comes to my mind that that sentence, that quote from Roosevelt, is a very beautiful one. It says, keep your eyes on the stars, but remember to keep your feet on the ground. So that's what I would say to
you. I think Casey Kasem said that too.
Yeah, how
did you say it? I didn't say it.
That's Casey. Rascal Flatts and Shakira, ladies and gentlemen, thank you so much for being here. Now, we are going to get back to your results. Of course, this is your bottom three. Bring down the lights, and here we go again. Mike, Casey, and Siobhan. Mike, let me ask you, how does it feel to be standing here in this moment again, so close to potentially leaving the competition?
Well, tonight is different because everybody did well last night, so there's no shame in the bottom three, you know. That's just the way it stacks up. We all had a good night, you know, so it's all good.
Well, Mike, once again, you are safe. Take a seat with the gang over there. He's right. Everybody did have such a great week this week. It's so tough to say goodbye to anybody, but it's down to Casey and Siobhan. Who leaves us? Find out live next. after weeks of pouring their hearts out on this stage. We find out who leaves us tonight, either Casey or Siobhan. Good luck to both of you. Dim the lights, and here we go. A construction worker and a glass blower both have come so far in this competition, grown so much, but only one can move on. The person who goes home tonight is Siobhan Magnus. Casey, you are safe. Siobhan Magnus, everybody. An independent spirit, laser focus, incredible work ethic. And they're on their feet. I know you did this for your sisters. You've talked about that before. What impact do you think it's made on both you and your sisters being a part of this show?
Hopefully a big one. I did my best, and I hope that I was able to show them what we're all capable of.
You were always true to yourself and very strong. Siobhan Magnus, let's take a look at her time.
You really are a funny little thing, aren't you? Because we just don't know what you're going to do each time.
Simon has no idea. She is very peculiar.
My racing heart is just the same.
That last song was fantastic, by the way.
Thank you very much.
I mean, seriously changed everything.
So I say, think I better leave right now.
I can't get over that note. I don't know how you do that.
You are why I love music. I was captivated. You're spectacular.
Somebody better show me out. I'm here for my baby sisters, who are my whole world. Nothing's gonna change that.
I could never have dreamed that I'd be at this point. It's just unreal. She's doing things that are, you know, I don't think most people can do. And I'm very impressed. I'm very impressed with her voice. I think I better leave right now.
Why is one? One more time on the stage. Siobhan Magnus, take it away, darling.
You better think about what you're trying to do to me. Yeah, let your mind go, let yourself be free. Let's go back, let's go back, let's go way on the way back when. I didn't even know you, you couldn't have been too much more intense.
Just stop.
But it don't take too much IQ to see what you're doing to me. You better think about what you're trying to do to me. Oh, think that you might go let yourself be free. Oh, freedom.
Freedom.
Freedom. Freedom. Oh, freedom.
Hey, think about it. You think about it.
There ain't nothing you could ask. I could answer you with
Siobhan Magnus.
You're still our star.
Before we say goodnight, go give him a hug. Give Simon a hug. I know he's a big fan, even though those notes he gave you a hard time every once in a while. Give him a hug.
Me.
He's gonna miss you.
I'm gonna miss you.
Thank you. Oh, yeah. You did great, Taylor.
I'll see you tomorrow on my show.
Randy, as we say goodnight.
All right, you're gonna sing on my show.
What advice do you have for Siobhan as an artist as she continues on?
Keep being yourself. You learn how to be an artist on the show and face all the adversity and everything. I think that you got an amazing career in front of you. Do it.
Do it.
Do it. Be about it.
Thank you so much for watching, ladies and gentlemen. That is all for tonight. Thank you to our judges. Ricky Miner and the band, as always, baby. Thank you. Thanks for voting at home. Don't forget, next week, Harry Connick Jr., Sinatra Songs. Your local news is next. Good night, America.